school, a body of Ganyakahaga people, and they looked at the children and they said, "I smell Indian blood." And that story never ever faded from my memory because of how scared my grandmother would tell me. She was so afraid to speak her language. She didn't teach my mom, she didn't teach my uncles or my aunts, but she taught us. When she was old enough, when she was older, she finally said that she had enough courage that she was healing. So she taught us Ganyakeha. And my grandfather, he went to the Navy, he was in World War II, and then he was the BA of the 440 local iron workers, and they built this country. Him and my uncles and all of our brothers and sisters. And my grandmother, she also was a hard worker in a time where women weren't supposed to work. She went and she worked in the artillery factories and she built the guns for the war. And my grandparents were so strong. My grandfather told me how when he went to school, after he escaped residential school, he used to row his rowboat across the St. Lawrence to get to school so he could make money so nobody would ever take his kids. And what my grandparents taught me, she named me Gainalusta, which translates to making things beautiful. And I work for Nakuset as an intergenerational trauma counselor. And what I was taught from my grandparents was never to give up. And that's what I hope to spread and what I hope to teach anybody. Any person that we come across, maybe we won't change the whole world, but we're gonna change every little corner that we touch. So I don't want anyone to ever hang their heads down or be ashamed of where you come from. If you know your language, even if it's just one word, speak your language a day. And I want you to say it all with me, that we're still here. Ready? We are still here.
We are still here.
Y'all go up.
Bradley, she's our intergenerational trauma worker at Miyaskamin. And now, I would like to introduce Maya Kusumno Malen.
Oui, bonjour, ça va être en français. Je ne sais pas s'il y en a qui étaient ici dans l'étude, mais je vais partager de la poésie donc avec vous. Merci d'être là, à nous supporter. Pour toutes ces aînés qui ont marché avec nous et qui marchent encore avec nous. Tu es né enfant de la toundra. Moi, je suis un pont fragile. Tu marches au territoire, aux quatre vents. Ce langage aux sonorités lointaines. Ton visage ciselé de rides séculaires raconte une légende de survivance. Première famille ici étrangère, tu trouvais le sentier de mon cœur. Tes murmures de brise douce, tes yeux d'aurore lunaire. Vois en l'avenir inou des mouvances d'espérance. Prodigue tes conseils de sagesse à l'enfant que je suis, vide de sa culture, Yamé no Kum. Il y a des jours où tu sens l'orage, tes pensées dangereuses, risquées, te font mal. Tu ne crois plus en ton cœur, tu ne crois plus en ta guérison. Soudain, un cœur de voix du passé surgit de la brumante mélancolie. Sans les ancêtres qui te murmurent le courage et le chemin. Sans nos courbes rire dans tes rêves et caresser le lichen. Vois Mouchou heureux en cette heure qui te chuchote les secrets des légendes. Pour toutes ces femmes qui ne sont jamais revenues, pour toutes ces jeunes filles aussi, tu n'as pas de nom. Dis-moi, belle sauvagesse, as-tu hurlé avant de périr? Où le silence a-t-il été ton dernier râle, quand la rivière t'a accueilli? Ton corps fait pour honorer notre terre, d'amour, de danse et de chant. Tes bras frêles pour combattre bravement, pour tenir à ta vie de 6-1. Là où tes territoires ne sont que poussière. Dans la poésie de tes derniers moments, tu n'as même pas de nom. Le murmurer pour ramener ta mémoire fait de moi une dissidence sacrilège. Souviens-toi, bel enfant du registre, tu n'as pas de nom. Ton œil noir brille d'une ultime lumière. Tes traits exquis et délicats ne vieillissent plus. Tes épitaphes seront murales, car désormais tu auras un nom.